Are you ready to take your slate engravings from your diode laser to the next level? If so, stick around. Hey everybody, my name is Sam and welcome back to Samcraft. In today's video, I'm going to show you how I take a raw, unfinished piece of slate, tweak some settings in my laser software, and get color results from my diode laser. In this video, I'm going to be showcasing the brand new xTool F1 dual laser machine. Dual lasers, what does that mean? It means there's two inside this one little case. There is a 455 blue light diode laser and a 1064 nanometer infrared laser, all in one. With a 10 watt diode built into this machine, it means the F1 is capable of cutting wood, leather, and other materials while also engraving on a variety of materials, if not almost every material out there. What I'm going to be showing you guys today is how this machine engraves on slate, but like I said in the opening, this will apply to any machine out there. Any of your diode or infrared lasers, you'll still be able to get this quality results. So even if you don't have this particular machine, stick around and I'll show you how it's done. At the heart of this whole process, you are going to need to do engraving tests. These guys right here, the things that you see me practice and preach a lot on my channel. The reason you need to run these engraving tests is so that you can find at what speed and power range does your machine give the different color effects. There you go. That's the secret. I guess I just spoiled it for you. The way you get the colors is by adjusting speed and power. What I have here are four different engraving tests that I ran on the xTool F1. First up is the blue light engraving test, ranging from 20 to 200 millimeters per second and 100% power all the way down to 10. The second is a faster engraving test for the blue light that ranges from 175 millimeters per second all the way up to 400 millimeters per second. And again, ranging power speed from 100% all the way down to 10. I repeated the same tests with the infrared laser built into the F1, so I have a total of four different engraving tests, four different grids and varieties of outcomes to pick and choose from. For the purpose of this video, to show off the awesome sauce of the F1 having two lasers in one, I will be using the infrared and the diode lasers to create the overall color scheme, but you could easily do this just with your diode laser. Don't feel like you're excluded, don't feel like it's only a club for F1 groupies. This is capable with your machine too. That being said, let's take our engraving test, hop over to the computer, pull up our file, and start to assign settings to our layers to give the colored effect. All right guys, I've launched xTool Creative Space and connected to the xTool F1 machine. This is not something that's specific to Lightburn. In fact, the F1 is compatible with Lightburn as well. I'm just choosing to use xTool Creative Space for this because it's the machine and software that most everyone who gets it is going to be using day one, and I might as well learn this and create some content showing it as well. All right, with my design imported, I'm just going to center it here on the machine's plate, and then using my digital calipers, I will measure the object I'm going to engrave. In this case, a slate drink coaster, find my maximum dimensions, and scale this design to fit. The next thing I want to do is create different layers for the different colors I want to have in my final outcome. This can be whatever you want to choose. This is definitely where you can get creative or not be that creative, whatever you want to do. So I'm going to spend a little bit of time separating out this image into the different layers, and then we'll talk about the settings and colorization results next. So at this point, I have my image separated out into different layers that I want to correspond with different colors on the slate. So my next step is to use my engraving test right here that I have right in front of me and assign the layers to the different colors that I want. The cool thing about xTool Creative Space, and Lightburn has a similar feature, is that once I have them built in once, if I save them as a custom setting, I can easily load it back in. So here, in this example, I want the red layer, layer number two, to be the darkest one. So I'm going to set the processing type to engrave, and then I'm going to click this drop down and choose slate gold slash blue. The term slate gold blue is something that I named in here. It's a custom setting that I saved, and it tells me this is a setting for slate. It gives me a gold color and uses the blue light laser. You can name whatever you want, but for me, this is what kind of makes sense. So it's easy. I have that one done. I move on to the next. The orange layer, I'm going to choose to engrave it, drop down my setting, and I want that one to be tan. So I choose slate tan hyphen blue. The yellow one, engrave, drop down, and that one's going to be slate gray with the blue light laser. And then last but not least is the blue ones. That one is going to be set to engrave, and I'm going to use the infrared laser for this in a layer that I termed light gray. It's what gives me the brightest results on slate and almost white. It does the best. So the way the xTool F1 works, you've got some settings down here at the bottom right. I can click to frame the total output, or I can click to do the outline that's running on the machine there. I would place my material. When I'm done with that, I've got it where I want. I click on stop framing, and then I click on the start button, and that generates the G-code and files, and then we'll send it over to the machine when I click the start button here, and we'll hear a beep to signify that the machine has received the file. There you go. At this point, we're done at the computer, we go to the machine, we close everything up, and we press the button on the side of the case to run the job. Alright guys, so I've got the laser here on my roll around table, and I've got it set up this way so that you're able to see it a little bit better for video. Normally, this guy lives right over there next to my xTool P2 and my comm marker fiber laser. It's a lot easier to work from there, but it makes for difficult areas and angles to shoot a video from. So I have the slate that come with the F1. We're going to use this for our test here today. I have a spray bottle here with isopropyl alcohol. I'm just going to give a little bit of a spritz here, and then use a microfiber cleaning cloth just to wipe off the surface, remove any kind of residue or anything that might fight us a little bit on our engraving job. That stuff dries quickly, so now we're ready to load it into the laser and run the job. Lift up the safety shield here, and you're going to notice that there is a red and blue dot that always shows when the machine is on and not running. These are what you use to focus the device. To raise and lower the laser head, you twist this knob over here on the right, and it uses an electric motor to lift or lower the head to focus it. In order to focus it, you move it up or down until the two dots become one on top of your surface. With the laser head focused on the surface of my material, I'm going to click on the framing button in xTool Creative Space. It's then going to project the outline of the job. I can then position it, move it around as I want to, and get it in the right spot. When I'm happy with that outcome, I click on the stop framing button in xTool Creative Space. Then I'll click on the green start button at the bottom of the screen. It shows me the preview of the file that's about to be run. I click on the green start button at the top right hand corner. The beep signifies that it's transferred the information from the software to the laser. I then lower my safety shield and press the button on the side of the machine to start the job. For the sake of the video, I'm going to be raising the safety shield and I will run this open air. I will, however, be wearing my laser safety glasses. These are a pair that I purchased and they work great. They are rated for use with infrared and diode laser, and they are the best things to use. Again, this is just for the video. If I were in here in my shop without you guys here and the camera stuff in the way, this safety shield would be all the way down and closed as it always should be. There we go. A total runtime, 7 minutes and 52 seconds. And here we have our Nacho Average Dad colorized drink coaster straight off the xTool F1. Pretty cool, huh? I love the detail you're able to get with galvo lasers or diode lasers in general. Their smaller laser dot size allow you to get super fine detail. Like the little sombrero band with the circles, perfectly great. The little triangle cutouts look awesome as well. And really, it's one of the sharpest quality engraving jobs you can get without going super big budget with fiber or UV lasers. As you also saw, this is not very difficult to do, right? I probably have demystified or torn down the curtain, I don't know what the phrase is, but basically showed you guys how something that at first you would think, oh cool, but I guess I probably need a really expensive laser to do that, is not true. This shows you the benefit and reason you do engraving, speed, and power test on materials. Without doing that, I would not have been able to see that I had a wide range from gold to tan to gray to even whitish with that infrared laser had I never done the engraving test to begin with. If you have an xTool F1 or another xTool machine and you want to make this yourself, I tell you what, I'll put this file for free over on my website. It will be the xTool Creative Space format file, so if you use Lightburn, you will also get the vector, but you won't have the layer settings. Either way, I'll hook you guys up. I want you to be able to possibly get yourself your own Nacho Dad coaster here, but also have the ability to make these, see the settings, and if you want, if you have an F1 and it evens out on your settings, you can save them as custom settings as well. If not, or if you use Lightburn, I sell all of the engraving and cutting test files, both in Lightburn format and as an xTool Creative Space native file. I sell them on my website. There's a link to them down below as well. If you want to go get them, run all the tests, and find out what settings work perfect for you on either Slate or any other material. Well, this wraps up the video for this project with the F1. If you're interested to see more content around it, stick around. This little guy is in the workshop for a while, and I have been running through a lot of tests with not only Slate, but wood engraving and cutting, acrylic engraving and cutting, and of course, metal with that infrared laser. As always, I appreciate you guys watching. If you have any questions or comments, leave them for me down below. Otherwise, take care, and I'll see you guys next time in the workshop.